from the time you all been waiting for, welcome to the Tiger's Den. Florida Gateway College faced our opposing team, the Alabama Coastal North Star Coyotes. Starting for Alabama Coastal, number 0, Rontavious Blackshear. Number 3, Mikey McIntosh. Number 10, Abdul Baya. Number 21, Joshua Whitehurst. And number 35, Ethan Anderson, coached by head coach Chuck Taylor and assistant Wesley Gillum. And now, ladies and gentlemen, what you all have been waiting for, stand up on your feet and make some noise for our Timberwolves. So the starting lineups for the Timberwolves today will be number 0, freshman from Baton Rouge, Louisiana,
live from the Howard Center. Today, your hometown Timberwolves take on the Alabama Coastal Coyotes. It's the Timberwolves versus the Coyotes here live from the Howard Center. Sparse crowd on this beautiful Saturday afternoon here at the Howard Center. Crowd of about 200. But of course, you can catch all the action right here on FGC TV on Comcast Channel 8 in Lake City, Facebook Live, or the YouTube channel of FGC. And we're just about to have tip-off here at the Howard Center. The Wolves will start Lewis, Weber, Ty Wright, Phillips, and Axel Holmquist. For Alabama Coastal, the Coyotes, they'll start Blackshear, McIntosh, Bayou, Whitehurst, and Anderson. Coyotes have the possession here, just starting here at the Howard Center. Coyotes come in with an overall record of 2-3. The Wolves with a huge win over their arch competition, Santa Fe Saints, their Division I Saints. We won on Thursday night. All net for the Coyotes. Phillips will run the point for the Wolves. Holmquist is in the first outing the other night, was out with an ankle injury. Good to see him back in the game. Weber's going to try to pop the three. Holmquist with the board. He'll try to take the shot off there. Here comes the Coyotes. Two-pointer by the Coyotes. Phillips with the missed layup. Wolves are forcing the ball early here with 18:25 left here in the first half. Another three-pointer by the Coyotes. Holmquist with the rebound. Here comes the Wolves. Ty Wright with the shot. Way off the mark. Rebound by Weber. Rebound by Oakley Lewis. Puts in the first 2 points for the Wolves with 17:55 here in the first half. Remain Coyotes ball. Nice hustle by Weber. The Wolves will press. Coming in for the Coyotes for the first time is Ozell Purify, the freshman guard. Holmquist with the boards. Lewis take the shot off the mark. Holmquist with the boards. A lot of people hustling for the balls. It is the Coyotes ball. Here comes Weber. Slam, bam, jam. Nice steal and slam, bam, jam by the sophomore Antoine Weber from Rochester, Minnesota. Basket by the Coyotes. Phillips with an errant pass, goes cross court. Slam, bam, jam for the Coyotes. Phillips got hung up and tried a cross court pass and was easily intercepted and stolen by the Coyotes. Weber to Holmquist, nice play there for the Wolves. 9-6 Coyotes over the Timberwolves with 6:14 here in the first half. You're watching FGC TV live from Comcast Channel 8. Also on Facebook Live, here comes the Wolves. Phillips with the basket. And finally on the YouTube channel of Florida Gateway College Television. Here comes Oakley with the ball, but he loses control. Wolves all over those boards. Holmquist going to try to put the ball up, off with a shot. Here comes Phillips. Off to Holmquist, and he's fouled as the Timberwolves take the first lead of the game with 14:55 here left in the first half. And we'll have an immediate timeout. We'll be back here in just a moment on FGC TV.
There are so many rewards in life. You coming into our home was one of the greatest rewards we could have ever had.
You know, it took 20 years and I got my third child who was 17 at the time.
It's so cool to watch the adult that you've become, and you really have done as much for us as you think we've done for you.
We're back here on FGC TV with the Florida Gateway College Timberwolves 10, the Coastal Alabama Coastal Coyotes 9. Small crowd here, about 175 people. Many of the students here at the student body of the Timberwolves have gone home a little early, I think, for Thanksgiving break. But still a nice crowd for a very busy Saturday afternoon in Lake City. A lot of football games, college games going on. I know the Gators are playing today. Good to see Lenny Pinchock, executive director of the Florida Gateway College Foundation. Also Megan Logan, the attorney for Florida Gateway College here today, all with their families. Special shout out to them. Also, Brian Blue-Eyed Lloyd is here at the game as usual. Best admissions counselor going. Holmquist with the back end. All net. 11-9 with the Wolves with the lead. Thank you. remain Coyotes ball. Seconds left on the shot clock for the Coyotes. Here comes the Wolves. Ty Wright is fouled as he goes up to the hoop. He'll shoot two for the Wolves. Wright, the freshman from Lake City, Florida, Columbia High prospect. All net on his first one. Makes both for the Wolves. Coming in for his first action of the day is Tariq Pitts, 6'7" center from Niceville, Florida. Nice basket by the Coyotes. Phillips going to pop the three. 17-16-11 for the Wolves. Three-pointer off, but Coyotes regain. Here comes the Wolves. Phillips with that cross-court pass again. Pitch back out to Weber. Weber gets the screen. Off for the three-pointer. Remains Coyote ball. With 13:19 left here in the first half, you're watching FGC TV. Foul by the Wolves. Their first foul, first team foul. Foul on number 15. DeMaceo Shepherd, a freshman from Lake City, Florida, just getting in the game, and he has his first foul. Coyotes make the first one. Misses the second. Here comes Antoine Weber. Wright is off with the three-pointer. Little trap there by the Wolves. Oakley Lewis diving for the ball, but it remains Coyotes ball. Nice to see all the cheerleaders out here today again. Cheering on their hometown men's basketball team. Good to see our director of advisement, Rebecca Thomas, and her husband here at today's game. Weber with the rebound. Here comes Phillips. Phillips off to Oakley, misses the easy shot, but Weber's there. And a basket by DeMaceo Shepherd, freshman, his first 2 points of the game. Coming to the scorer's table is Ty Wright coming in back. Wide open. The Coyotes for the three-pointer. Bad pass by Oakley. Coyotes regain control. Easy basket by the Coyotes. Pitts with the shot, banks it in for the Wolves. Wolves full court press. Backing off now. Here comes Emmanuel Phillips. Slam, bam, jam from Okeechobee, Florida. Emmanuel Phillips, the sophomore. Nice basket by the Coyotes. Wolves with the lead, 22-16 here. Weber cross court to Oakley Lewis, off the mark. Nice block by Pitts, but remains Coyotes ball. As we take a little time out here, I want to read you the commercial for our lead sponsor for all Timberwolf basketball, Security Safe Company. Security Safe has more than 35 years serving Florida families and businesses with personalized attention and dedicated customer service. Security Safe is built on quality, reliability, and innovation. Contact Security Safe today to start protecting your home or business with the best. That's Security Safe Company, the premier sponsor of all Florida Gateway College Timberwolf basketball. Ball remains Coyotes with 10-16 here at the first half here at the Howard Center. You're watching FGC TV here from the Howard Center. Coyotes ball. Wolves with the ball. Nice reverse layup by number four, T'Juan Wright. And with 9:24, I think we'll be taking a media timeout. We'll take a break in the action right here on FGC TV. We'll be back in one moment. Welcome back here on FGC TV, where the Florida Gateway College Timberwolves have a lead 24-18 over Coastal Alabama Coyotes. 9:21 left here in the first half. Will be Timberwolf basketball. Seeing his first action of the day is Jazz and Johnson, the sophomore from New York City. Also seeing time is Nathaniel Mobley, and his foot was on the line, so it'll be Coyotes basketball with 8:59 here, first half. Coyotes with the ball. Foul on number 15 for the Wolves. That's his second foul. That's Demiseo Shepherd, the freshman from Lake City, Florida, from Columbia High. Coyotes make the first one. Coming back in for the Wolves is number 5. Mayo Phillips, the sophomore from Okeechobee, Florida, via the Virgin Islands. Coyotes make both. Here comes the press from the Coyotes. Johnson with the ball out to Shepherd, and he's fouled, and he'll shoot two for the Wolves. Shepherd makes the first for the Wolves. What a graphic here on FGC TV, producing by our technical crew led by Lance Bass, followed by Anthony Free. I think Bobby Charles is in the studio also today. The Wolves with the lead, 26-20 over the Coyotes with 8:30 left here in the first half, here live from the Howard Center. You're watching FGC TV on Comcast Channel 8, of course on Florida Gateway College's Facebook pages, and also Florida Gateway College YouTube channel, FGC TV. All the action. Crowd starting to fill in here at the Howard Center, about 260 people here. Not a bad crowd for a beautiful Saturday afternoon here in Lake City. Bad pass by the Wolves. Turnaround jumper, hook shot by the Coyotes. Good to see our flag football coach Ricky out here watching the men's Timberwolf basketball game. Johnson with the pop. He is fouled and he'll shoot two. Coming back in for the Wolves will be Antoine Weber. Johnson, a sophomore from New York City. He misses the first for the Wolves. Weber replacing Ty Wright, the freshman from Columbia High. Johnson's all net on the second one. Nice basket by the Coyotes. Johnson puts it in for the Wolves. He has 3 points coming off the bench early for the Wolves. Board by Weber. Here comes Johnson. Weber thought about putting out that three-pointer far. Phillips going to drive to the basket, loses control, and it will be the Coyotes' ball. Trap being applied by the Wolves. Three-pointer by the Coyotes off the pace. Rebound by Mobley. Here comes Jazz and Johnson off to Weber. Weber puts it in for the Wolves. Take a 7-point lead with 6:24 left here in the first half. 31-24 over Coastal Alabama Coyotes. Air ball by the Coyotes. It will be the Wolves basketball. Coach Ruiz calling out Gateway's play. Here's Holmquist. Can't put it in for the Wolves, but Weber gets the board. He'll drive the basket. Nothing there, but he pushes it in for the Wolves. Follows it up. Grit and determination there. Phillips with the ball, puts in the layup, steals and puts in the ball for the Wolves. Timeout by Coastal Alabama here with 5:14 left. We're going to stay here on FGC TV. O'Neill Companies, a sponsor here for Timberwolf basketball, has 51 years of experience, knowledge, and resources. Expect beauty, durability with custom-built O'Neill products. O'NeillCompanies.com, located at 212 Southeast Hickory Drive, Lake City, Florida, 32025. That's O'Neill Companies, 51 years serving the Lake City community. Leading scorer for the Wolves already in the first half is Amaya Phillips, a sophomore from Okeechobee, Florida, followed by Antoine Weber with a total of 5 points, followed by Jazzin Johnson, the sophomore off the bench with 3 points. You're watching FGC TV live from the Howard Center. Good to see our AD here as usual. Him with his family. Great family entertainment here at the Howard Center. Remember, the Snack Shack is open, sponsored by Sun Stop Convenience Stores, the premier convenience store of all of Lake City, providing all those goodies. Where else can you come to a basketball high quality for free and get a hot dog and a drink or a soda for only $5? Make sure you stop by next time here at the Howard Center live or watch all the action here on FGC TV. Next home game for the Wolves is this coming Tuesday, November 21st, against Johnson University. Come here and watch all the action. It's at 7 p.m. Eight seconds on the shot clock by the Johnson with the steal. Loses control. Mobley grabs the ball, but he travels. Got ahead of himself on that one, got excited. Coming back in for the Wolves is Wright. He'll replace Mobley. Two Lake City gentlemen replacing each other. Leading scorer, of course, this season for the Wolves is Antoine Weber, the sophomore from Rochester, Minnesota, followed by Amaya Phillips, the sophomore from Okeechobee, Florida. Nice basket by the Coyotes. 9-point lead here for the Wolves with 4:21 left here in the first half from the Howard Center. Holmquist with the ball at the top of the key. Phillips trying to penetrate. It'll be a jump ball. And it will remain Timberwolf ball. The arrow is in the Wolves' favor. Great to see a lot of children and kids at the games today. Great family entertainment here at the Howard Center. Weber going to pop the 15, all net for Antoine Weber. Foul on Phillips, his first. It's only a second foul on the Wolves. I think they actually have three fouls. I think the scorer's desk has it wrong. Wolves have gone small except for Holmquist with this rotation currently on the floor. Phillips going to try to pop the 18-footer. All net, fade away for Amaya Phillips. Wolves with the largest lead of the game, 11 points with 3:28 left here in the first half. You're watching FGC TV. Nice block by Wright will remain Coyotes ball. Seven seconds on the shot clock for the Coyotes. Steal by Wright. Layup for Phillips. Miles Phillips having a very good first half for the Wolves. Here comes Johnson, loses control of the ball. It's Phillips to Weber, who loses control of the ball. Puts it in anyway. For the Wolves. Three-pointer by the Coyotes, all net. Holmquist with the basket, but we have an injury on the Wolves on the court. Trainer will have to go out there. Ty Wright is out, is on down to the green, but he's going to be okay, shaking it off for the Wolves. Coach Riz talking to the ref right there. Cheerleaders getting ready to be here for the halftime show that they do every time here at the Howard Center. Great performances by those 10 cheerleaders. Just with 2 minutes left here in the first half. Thank you. Coyotes penetrate, but nothing there. Here comes Phillips. Phillips out to Oakley Lewis. Weber was thinking about it. Phillips going to try to pop one off the mark for the Wolves. Give a shout out to some of the cheerleaders before they perform this afternoon. Markiki Chambers is out there. Gabby Daniels, Selena Girardo, Tasadi Irvine, Jocelyn Jenkins, Tiona Myers, Ayana Salmon, Aaron Starling, Madison Taylor, and Akakiri Wheeler. That's the 10 brand new cheerleaders for the Wolves this season. Please come out and see them at their halftime shows at all the home team men's basketball games. Basket by the Coyotes. Holmquist will try to pop it out there, in and out for the Wolves. Nice block by the Wolves. Holmquist with the ball. Weber's going to drive the basket. No foul called by the Wolves. Jump ball, and it will be. Coyotes basketball with 33.4 seconds left in this first half. You're watching FGC TV with the Florida Gateway College Timberwolves 45, the Coastal Alabama Coyotes 33. Remember, fitness and nutrition 1075, kickstarting healthy lifestyles. For your personal training, fitness, and nutritional needs, contact Fitness and Nutrition 1075. Located at 144 Southwest Waterford Court, number 105, Lake City, Florida, 32025. That's Fitness and Nutrition, 1075. 10 seconds left here in the first half. Phillips with the foul. Nope. And the Coyotes will shoot three. I was wrong. Technical foul on the Coyotes. And Phillips will shoot it, so there's no foul on the Wolves. Something called bobbing, they said. Phillips makes the first one, only shoots one technical. And it will be Coyotes basketball. Kind of confused with that, but bringing the ball under the basket. Oh, excuse me, yes, under the basket. Coyotes will bring it in with 9.3 seconds left here in the first half at the Howard Center. Nice move by the Coyotes. Design play. Wolves will have to look for that down the road. 1 second left. Phillips just misses the three-pointer. After the first half ends, it's the Florida Gateway College Timberwolves 46, the Coastal Alabama Coyotes 35. We'll be back in just a few minutes here on FGC TV.
For those who value learning, whether it's in the classroom, through field experience, or even beyond the U.S. borders, for those who value a greater tomorrow, there is Florida Gateway College. FGC is home to students, faculty, staff, and community members who are moving forward together for the greater good of all who enter its doors. Go further together at FGC.
STEM is the discipline of hard numbers. Precise, no margin for error.
Dare to forget that. Dare to have fun with it. Get weird with it. Dare to get messy or just mess it up. Dare to program something internet-breaking, record-breaking. Dare to blow their minds. Dare to try. Dare to fail. Dare to keep daring. Dare to learn the difference between organic, sedimentary, and non-foliated metamorphic rock. Get outside. Find those rocks. Dare to be homeroom famous, a high school fable. Dare to send those old STEM theories flying past the neighbor's house into outer space. And for the love of STEM, dare bigger. Dare to code. Dare to invent. Dare to explore. Dare to STEM. Check out She Can STEM to get started.
Born ready. On your mark, ready, get set, go. I hope y'all ready. I hope y'all ready. I hope y'all ready. Look at the time, oh no, I gotta go and get it. I was born ready, ay. Check the time, check the score, oh we still winning. Yeah, we still lit, ay. Top floor, top seat, yeah we big business. Woo, yeah we in the building. Real, it ain't about how you start, but how you finish. Sprinting to the finish line, ready? Ready?
Thank you.
scores for the Wolves with 14 points is the sophomore Amaya Phillips from Okeechobee, Florida, followed by the sophomore All-American from Minnesota, Antoine Weber. Followed up by that is Demaseo Shepherd with 4 points off the bench. Jasmine Johnson with 3 points off the bench. And Tyron Wright with 4 points. And Tariq Pitts with 2 points. Also, the Wolves have Axel Holmquist with 7 points and lots of rebounds. You're watching FGC TV live from the Howard Center. Remember, all the home games, Timberwolf basketball, are sponsored by Security Safe Company. Wolves with the ball. Lewis down to Holmquist. Holmquist looking, gonna try to do the layup, he's blocked. Weber with the ball, hustling after the ball. It's Coyote direction. Coyote has an injury on the floor, and it will be their ball. Coyote's twisted his ankle. It's number 0, Rontavious Blackshear, the freshman guard. Coming in for the Coyotes is number 20, John McCants, freshman guard. Timberwolves trainer will go take a look at the Coyotes injured player. Nice steal by Oakley Lewis. Off to Phillips. Phillips trying to avoid the charge. Laid it up. It was short. Here comes Lewis. Here comes Phillips again. Basket counts. And Phillips will try to do the back end of a three-pointer. McCants thought he had position. It was a charge. Good to see Vice President Tony Cardenas getting people their food in the crowd here. A little backed up at the Snack Shack, sponsored by Sun Stop Convenience Store. Phillips makes the back end. It will be Coyote's ball with the Wolves with a 14-point lead with 18:55 left here in the second half, 49-35. Coyotes with the basket. Oh no, not a shot clock problem here again, ladies and gentlemen. We don't need another 15 minute. Both of them are working. That's a good sign here at the Howard Center. Here comes the Coyotes, they have a 3-on-2 lead. Nice block by Weber, clean break. Slam, bam, jam. Ty Wright from Columbia High. Whoa, some bodies falling down there at the Howard Center. Antoine Weber did a flip there. Oakley Lewis with the foul, the Wolves' first team foul, first of the second half. You're watching FGC TV here from the Howard Center with the Wolves with a 14-point lead. Watch all the action here on Comcast Channel 8 in Lake City. Of course, the YouTube channel, FGC YouTube, and of course, all our Facebook Live accounts.
Thank you.
Oh, boy. Another clock problem here. Well, give us another timeout here at the Wolf Basketball. Remember, HCA Florida Lake City Hospital is committed to offering advanced healthcare services with a compassionate, patient-focused approach in the community. We live here and work here and are part of the Lake City community. That's HCA Florida Lake City Hospital. Shot clock seemed to be working. Seems to be a difference on the clocks with one with 18-18, the other one 18-17. I know my math. Don't ask me to do much more than arithmetic, division, and subtraction, but also gives me an opportunity to do a shout out to the Columbia Drip Bar. Be restored, be refreshed, be healthy. Revitalize your wellness at Columbia Drip Bar. Experience personalized drips for immediate results and long-lasting vitality. Columbia Drip Bar specializes in IV solutions to do better many aspects of your well-being. Columbia Drip Bar is located at 2218 U.S. Highway 90, Suite 102 in Lake City, Florida, and you can find them on the web at columbiadripbar.com. Another great sponsor of Florida Gateway College Timberwolf basketball. Scoreboard on the visiting team is not working. Weber with the basket, and he'll shoot the three. We got to get these scoreboards and clocks fixed here during the semester break. I don't know what is going on, but we want to have a first-class atmosphere here at the college and need to get those scoreboards fixed. Weber misses the back end. Nice hustle by number four. Ty Wright. Remain Wolves basketball. Got Wright, Phillips, Olmquist, Weber, and Lewis on the floor for the Wolves. Kicked by the Coyotes, remain Wolves basketball. Special shout out to our technical crew, led by Lance Bass, who makes it all happen, followed by Anthony Free, and also Bobby Charles from the ID department. Phillips going to try a short 15-footer, short there. Here comes the Coyotes. They have the numbers. And he is fouled by Ty Wright, and they'll shoot two. The Coyotes will shoot two. Remember, today's game is also sponsored by Sunstop Food Stores. That's the Snack Shack, where you can get all your goodies at the Snack Shack. Get a hot dog and a beverage for just $5. And remember, nothing beats a Sunstop snack break. We have the Battle of the Animals today here at the Howard Center, where the Coyotes are down by 15 to the hometown Timberwolves. Coyotes make the back end. Comes Oakley, Lewis off to Phillips. We'll have Weber run the offense for the Wolves. Nice little 10-foot turnaround by number four. Ty Wright, the freshman from Lake City, Florida. Foul and the basket for the Coyotes. Coyotes will shoot the back end. Coming in for the Wolves will be Jazzin Johnson. 13-point lead here for the Wolves. Comes to press by the Coyotes. Going to try to trap Antoine Weber. Here comes Jazzin Johnson. Wolves continue to go small right now. Phillips off to Holmquist. Holmquist puts the basket in for the Wolves. Three-pointer by the Coyotes. Nice rebound by the Coyotes. Nice hustle by the Wolves. Basket by the Coyotes. This game is not over by any means, ladies and gentlemen. Wolves by 12 with 15:44 left here in the second half. Total crowd for today's game, 323, I've been told by the AD. Not a bad crowd for a Saturday afternoon. Offensive foul by the... foul on the Wolves, number 32, Holmquist, his second. 14 foul by the Wolves. Coming in for the Wolves is Jazzin Johnson. Going to give Emmanuel Phillips a little rest here. Ref is getting some instruction to the Coyotes that they need to take off their shirts before they enter the game. I don't know if that will warrant a bench tee, but he said that was the 17th time he's worn them. Nice steal here by Jazzin Johnson. Goes behind his back. Tries to do some razzle-dazzle off to... The Wolves will be shooting two. I'm not sure who. Johnson will be shooting two for the Wolves. Excuse me, Oakley Lewis will be shooting two for the Wolves. Lewis, a freshman from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Warnings on both Holmquist and McIntosh for the Coyotes. Next foul will be a technical on either one of them. Lewis makes the basket for the Wolves. .14:52 left on the clock. Foul on number one, Antoine Weber with the push. Fifth team foul, second foul on Weber. First foul on Weber according to the scorer's table.
Ha ha.
scorer's table saying it's time for immediate timeout. We'll take a break here in the action on FGC TV and be back in just a moment.
Inland Stores helps you save big at the pump. With the Sunny Saver debit card, you save up to 10 cents a gallon every time you fill up. Stop by any Inland store and pick up your Sunny Saver card. It's simple, it's safe, and there are no fees. Best of all, you'll start saving immediately. And while you're filling up, you can use your card to make in-store purchases. Go to your nearest Inland store and pick up your card today.
All right, we're back here on FGC TV with the score, the Florida Gateway College Timberwolves 59, the Coastal Alabama Coyotes 45. Coyotes with the ball with 14:50 left here in the second half. Two-pointer by the Coyotes. Johnson with 3 points, even though the one ref said it was two. Here comes the Coyotes to try to break the deficit to under 10. Wolves with the ball off the tie right. Misses the slam, bam, jam, but slam, bam, jam by Oakley Lewis, the freshman from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Another three by the Coyotes. Johnson looking to penetrate. Nothing there. Nice D by the Coyotes. They have a 2-1 lead here. Two foul on number four, Ty Wright. Coyotes will shoot two to try to get this deficit down below 10. Coming in for his first action of the game for the Wolves is number 43, Logan Godfrey, 6'7" freshman from Tallahassee, Florida. Coyotes make the first. This is the first. Here comes the Wolves. They let the Coyotes back into this game. Plenty of time left for the Coyotes with 13-18. Nice fadeaway jumper in and out for the freshman Logan Godfrey. And the basket for the Coyotes with 13:02. Down by only seven. Going to try to make the back end here to cut it to six. Coming back in at the scorer's table for the Wolves will be Mayo Phillips. Wolves going a little big here with Godfrey and Holmquist. Third team foul here on the Coyotes. The Wolves have six. Next one the Wolves make, they'll be in the bonus. Coyotes will be in the bonus.
You said that two,
Holmquist with the nice layup, nice pass. Here comes the Wolves with the press. And for the Wolves is number 10, Isaac Broxy. Foul on Holmquist. On the Wolves, and the Coyotes will shoot two. Foul was actually on Oakley Lewis. Lewis' second foul. The Wolves' seventh team foul. Coyotes missed the first. Beautiful graphics here on that parquet floor. Looks like the Celtics. In the old Celtic arena. Coyotes make the back end. Trail by 8, 63 to the hometown Florida Gateway College Timberwolves, 63. Coastal Alabama Coyotes, 55. You're watching FGC TV on Comcast Channel 8, Facebook Live, or FGC YouTube channel. Lewis going to try to pop one for 15-footer. Nothing there. In and out by Logan Godfrey. Just hasn't been able to get it to drop. Godfrey with the block for the Wolves. Nice basket by the Coyotes. Here comes the Wolves. Getting ahead of themselves here. The Wolves playing sloppy. Letting the Coyotes get back in this with a three-pointer. Three-point deficit only. Timeout here at the FGC Howard Center. Will take a full timeout here. Be back in just a moment.
If I could be you, and you could be me for just 1 hour. If we could find a way to get inside each other's minds. Walk a mile in my shoes. Walk a mile in my shoes. Well, before you abuse, criticize, and accuse, walk a mile in my shoes.
We're back here at the Howard Center. Remember, the premier sponsor of all Florida Gateway College men's Timberwolf basketball is Security Safe Company. Security Safe has more than 35 years serving Florida families and businesses with personalized attention and dedicated customer service. Contact Security Safe today to start protecting your home or business with the best. Security Safe is built on quality, reliability, and innovation. That's Security Safe Company, the premier sponsor, Florida Gateway College Timberwolf basketball. Wolves with the ball. Coach Ruiz is going big right now on the court. Holmquist with the ball, in and out. The ball is just not dropping for the Wolves right now. They are 0 for 7 the last 3 minutes. Three-pointer in and out, but they get a new 20 on the board, the Coyotes. Eight seconds left on the shot clock, and the Coyotes bring it out. They're going to try to pick there. They're trying a three-pointer. In and out, rebound by Gottfried. Here comes Broxy off to Weber, off to Holmquist. Puts it in for the Wolves. Thought he was going to get caught up when he put the ball down on the floor. But did a nice little turn shot. Wolves by 5, 65-60 with 10:39 left here in the first half, the second half. Three-pointer by the Coyotes, in and out. Nothing but Coyotes around Antoine Weber. Nice three-pointer. for the Coyotes. Weber was looking for the foul, did not get it. Remain Coyotes ball. Nice move by Weber to get to Godfrey. 10:01 left. We should be having an immediate timeout in just a moment. Holmquist is fouled. That's the fifth team foul for the Coyotes. Non-shooting foul. Officials are going to let this go and not have immediate timeout. Coming back in for the Wolves is Ty Wright. Going to replace Logan Godfrey, the freshman. Shirt was not tucked in. Holmquist, nothing there. Off the mark. Godfrey tried to get it back out. Here comes the Wolves. Three-pointer by the Coyotes. Comes right down to Holmquist. It will be Coyotes ball, 9:31. Coach Ruiz said, settle it down. Media timeout here with 9:31 left here in the second half. From the Howard Center, we're going to take a timeout here at FGC TV. We'll be back in just a moment.
I'd like to consider FGC as my first grand campus. I never thought I was going to go back to school or have the time to go back to school. Now my son, 12 years old, is looking at daddy after so many years, grabbing his books and going to school, and he's so proud. And I'm teaching him that you continue, my son, and you do what you have to, but be a man of your word and finish what you start.
Start your journey today at Florida Gateway College.
Leading scorers for the Wolves are Amaya Phillips, who has 17 points, followed by Antoine Weber, who has 12 points here. Those two are the leading scorers throughout the season so far, with seven games into the season. Shawana trying to get the crowd in here. Get him into the game here on Saturday here at the Howard Center. Foul on the Coyotes. It will be Timberwolves ball. Another close game here at the Howard Center. The other night we lost in overtime. I believe it was Albany Tech. College always plays this close. Holmquist looking for the shot, looking for the foul. He'll shoot two for the Wolves. Alex Holmquist is a freshman from Fleming Island, Florida. Center forward. Coach Ruiz is expecting big things out of Axel this season in his freshman year. All net on his first one. 6'8", center for the Wolves. Holmquist makes both of them. Two-pointer by the Coyotes. See if Mile Phillips can get some energy into this Wolf team. Leading scorer of the game, took a little refresher. Out to Lewis, out to Weber. Weber going to try a 15-footer. He's fouled. He'll shoot two for the Wolves. Weber's first is all net. Antoine came to the FGC as a walk-on last year. At the end of the season, he was named first-team Academic All-American, National Academic All-American. Came back for his second season. Expecting big things this season from the captain, one of the captains of the team. Nice rebound by Ty Wright. Comes Phillips. Nothing there. .808 left here in the second half. Wolves with a slim lead. One time they were up by 15. Lewis off to Holmquist. Nothing there. Timeout by the Wolves before they lost control. 30-second timeout. We're going to keep it here at the Howard Center. Fitness and Nutrition 1075, kickstarting healthy lifestyles. For your personal training, fitness, and nutritional needs, contact Fitness and Nutrition 1075. FitNutrition1075.com, located at 144 Southwest Waterford Court, number 105, Lake City, Florida, 32025. Ladies and gentlemen, remember the next home game for the Wolves will this coming Tuesday against Johnson University. Try to come out here to the Howard Center. It's at 7 p.m., but of course you can watch all the action here on Comcast Channel 8, Facebook Live, or on the YouTube channel, all brought to you by FGC TV Sports. Weber will inbound the ball for the Wolves. Off to Wright. Wright's going to press it, goes up left-handed. Oakley Lewis with the rebound is going to put it up for the Wolves and put it in, 71-67. Lewis was on the line. It will be Coyotes basketball. Refs putting 19 on the shot clock for the Coyotes, not a new 30. Special shout out to our technical crew. Once again, Lance Bass leading the crew, Anthony Free, Bobby Charles, and our student interns. Looking for great things. They're doing a lot more this year on graphics. Love that slam, bam, jam when we score. Ty Wright with the ball, gets it off to Phillips. Weber off to Holmquist. It will be Wolf ball. Both players hustling after the ball. Coming in for the Wolves, Godfrey, the number 43, the freshman from Tallahassee, Florida. Here comes the Coyotes. Makes the basket, 71-69. Wolves with a slim lead with 6:50 left here in the second half. Defense! Wolves have just not been fluid this second half. Lewis going to do a little hook shot. Nothing there. Coyotes can tie it all up here. Every game has been very close for the Wolves in losses and wins this season. Wide open. Tactical. Nope, no tactical. Hanging on the rim is Weber. Refs are talking about a technical here, I believe, for the Wolves. Not sure what the refs talking with the Coyotes coach about. Coyotes make the first. Godfrey coming in for Axel Holmquist. Ref is still talking with the Coyotes coach. I don't know what's going on down there, ladies and gentlemen. Godfrey with the rebound. Oakley Lewis with the three. Oh, net! Oakley Lewis. The Wolves needed that. Oakley Lewis with the foul. Wolves are over the limit, so the Coyotes will shoot the 1-1. Coyotes were on the line. It will be Wolf basketball. See if the Wolves can get some energy from Oakley Lewis's three-pointer here. Too close to call, ladies and gentlemen. 5:42 left here in the second half. You're watching FGC TV live from the Florida Gateway College campus, the Howard Center. Weber with the shot, way off the mark. He's trying to draw the charge, but nothing there. Here comes the Coyotes. Foul on Godfrey. Coyotes will shoot two. Great to see Rebecca Thomas here, Director of Advisement here at FGC. Also, Brian Blue-Eyed Lloyd is here, best admissions recruiter there is. Always recruiting, even at these games. Coyotes make both. 2-point lead for the Wolves. Lewis is going to try to pop one from 15 feet. It's all net. Oakley Lewis, last 5 points of the game for the Wolves. Nice basket by the Coyotes. Back and forth here at the Howard Center. Phillips running the point for the Wolves. Weber off to Godfrey. Godfrey, everybody there. Lewis will shoot two for the Wolves. That's the ninth team foul for the Coyotes. Next one, the Wolves will be in double bonus. The Coyotes are already in the double bonus with the Wolves with 10 fouls. Lewis, the freshman guard from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, misses the first one. Be very important as the season progresses that the Wolves practice those free throws in these tight, tight games. No basket, violation on the Wolves. We have a timeout here, full timeout. We'll be back on FGC TV in just a moment.
If you love them enough to crawl into a play place to get them to come down, then surely you'll check nhtsa.gov/the right seat to make sure they're in the right car seat.
We're back here on FGC TV. Next home game this coming Tuesday before Thanksgiving. Timberwolves will be taking on Johnson University. Live from the Howard Center, 7 p.m., 2 days before Thanksgiving. If I don't get a chance, wishing all of you and your families a blessed and happy Thanksgiving. Here from the FGC Timberwolves and the FGC College campus. One last shout out to Sunstop Convenience Stores, the sponsor of our Snack Shack. Sunstop featuring Eats Deli, located at 1166, just a mile away from here, the main campus, East Duval Street, and 2398 Southeast Bay Drive, Lake City. Sunstop, the premier convenience store here in Lake City. Coyotes with the ball. Can tie it all up here with 4:25 left here in the second half. Holmquist will come back in for the Wolves. Coyotes were on the line and we Wolf basketball. Coming back in, Godfrey, Holmquist coming back in for Godfrey. Be Holmquist, Phillips, Wright, Lewis, and Weber for the Wolves. Nice rebound by Wright. Saw Lewis coming, just a little too hard a pass. Good move by the Wolves, but nothing there. Yes, I can. Basket by the Wolves, 78-77. Rebound by Weber. Here comes Phillips. The Wolves have the numbers. Slam, bam, jam. Oakley Lewis, from the freshman from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Foul on Wright. Coyotes make the first one. See if the Coyotes make the back end. Makes both. 80-76. Wolves with a 4-point lead. Hustling down there. Timeout by the Wolves. Before the travel. Good call by Coach Ruiz. Wolves will inbound the ball. Weber to Oakley Lewis. Lewis misses the 7-footer. Here comes the Coyotes with just 2:20 left here in the second half. You're watching FGC TV live from the Howard Center. Three-pointer by the Coyotes. Nothing there. Rebound by Weber. Here comes Phillips. Coach Ruiz is telling him to slow it down, set it up. Just under 2 minutes left. Lewis gonna try to drive it for the Wolves. Puts it in, Oakley Lewis. Been the spark plug for the Wolves this second half. Timeout by the Coyotes with the score. The FGC hometown Timberwolves 82, the Coastal Alabama Coyotes 76. 30-second timeout. Gives me a chance to do a shout out to HCA Florida Lake City Hospital. HCA Florida Lake City Hospital is committed to offering advanced healthcare services with compassionate, patient-focused approach in the community. We live here and work here and are part of the Lake City community. That's HCA Florida Lake City Hospital, one of the sponsors of all our sports here at Florida Gateway College. Oakley Lewis this half has 11 points after only having 2 points this first half. It's 13 points, my statistician tells me. Good to have a statistician with me this afternoon. Much better than the computer stats that sometimes don't keep up with the actual game score. You're watching FGC TV, last 1 minute and 43 seconds of the second half with the Florida Gateway College Timberwolves 82, the Coastal Alabama Coyotes 76. Great to see our AD here and also our VP watching the game. Helping out at the Snack Shack as a little backup here at halftime, bringing food to all the patrons. That was great. Not Patriots, patrons. Inbounding for the Coyotes. Screen for the three-pointer. Nothing there. Holmquist with the boards for the Wolves. Getting it back to Weber. Weber's going to pop the three-pointer in and out for the Wolves, but put in by Ty Wright, number four, freshman from Lake City, Florida, Columbia High product. Great quality time, great points this afternoon. Three-pointer, all net by the Coyotes, keeping them in this game. Only five-point difference with just under a minute to play. Wolves ball. Both teams are in the bonus. Slowing it down for the Wolves. Wright going to put in the ball, but he's fouled. Ty Wright will shoot two for the Wolves. Wright's off with the first. That would have been a key. That is a key for the Wolves to make this one. Makes it on the back end, all net. 6-point lead for the Wolves. Coyotes going to look for a three to tie this thing up. Nothing but hustle by the... Here comes Ty Wright. Slam, bam, jam from the freshman from Lake City, Florida. It's all over, folks. 8-point game with 18 seconds left here. Three-pointer by the Coyotes. Timeout by the Coyote bench. With 13.9 seconds left here in the second half, the score, Florida Gateway College Timberwolves 87, the Coastal Alabama Coyotes 82. We're going to keep the action right here. Leading scorers for the Wolves this afternoon. Is Amile Phillips still with 17 points. Followed by Antoine Weber with 14 points. Followed by Wright, who has had 11 points. And Oakley Lewis, who has a total of 13 points for the Timberwolves. As we're watching the FGC cheerleaders do, Sweet Caroline. Great to see those young ladies out there. They are Marquise Chambers, Gabrielle Daniels, Selena Girardo, Tasadi Irvine, Jocelyn Jenkins, Tiona Myers, Ayana Salmon, Erin Starling, Madison Taylor, and Akiri Wheeler. Thank you, ladies, for supporting Timberwolf basketball. They're a sport this year. Cheerleaders, very happy to have them on the court for all the home games here at the Howard Center. Foul on right. They'll shoot two because they're in the double bonus, the Wolves. Wright makes the first one. It's all over, folks. That's the matter of what the final score will be. Wolves will go 5-3 overall in the season. Next home game is Tuesday night, 7 p.m. here at the Howard Center against Johnson University. Try to come out for the final home game before Thanksgiving. Wright makes both of them. Or you can catch all the action here on FGC TV. Three-pointer by the Coyotes. Timeout left here. 4-second game with 6 seconds on the clock. Reminder, FGC Timberwolf Athletics is expanding this year. We will have the first time since 2008, the Lady Softball Timberwolves competing with Coach Jimmy. They'll start this February. Make sure you come out to the Gene Williams Softball Complex, softball field, where all the action will take place, and we'll be announcing some of those games throughout the season. And also, don't forget about our national championship women's flag football team that won the national championships in their first year. Going to defend that championship. Have a well-recruited class with most of the sophomores back, expecting big things from those Lady Timberwolf football players. Their first game of the season will be late February. We'll be announcing all that action here on FGC TV. Wolves with the ball. Foul on Phillips. Phillips will shoot two for the Wolves. Coyotes trying to get back into this with not much time. Also trying to do some game management clock for future games. Very important for both teams to do that. Phillips, the leading scorer for the Wolves, will shoot two. Makes the first for the Wolves. Ref is going over some information with both coaches. Not sure what's going on. Nice shot of Antoine Weber. Thanks again for our technical crew, Lance Bass, Anthony Free, Bobby Charles, and our intern. Got 5.6 seconds left on the clock. What's going on here? Phillips makes both of them. Lewis will hold the ball, and the final score is the Florida Gateway College Timberwolves 91, Coastal Alabama Coyotes 85. We'll see everyone here next Tuesday at 7 p.m., Johnson University. Thanks for listening to FGC TV. That's all, folks.